relationships and communication. Good communication fosters relationships, closeness, and builds trust. But also conversely, trust fosters communication. Here again, we see the principle of circularity in giving and receiving that we have explored many times in the videos. Here are some of the communication abilities that we need. Number one, we need to express our feelings, thoughts, and beliefs and attitudes in an understandable and an appropriate manner. As part of building our abilities to communicate, we need to engage more broadly with society. So, for example, we need to learn about and interact with public institutions. People have to do this all the time. How we do it and how we deal with people at the bank or in government agencies is really important. I found that just being nice to people just helps the whole process. So we need to be able to engage with local communities on issues of public interest and express our views appropriately. So, for example, you could start a blog on an issue. You know, there are many free blog sites all over the web where you can start writing about issues that are important to you. You could write an article for a local paper. There's plenty of free ways to do this. Writing about our views is a good way to learn about ourselves. How you express yourself and how you respond to others. You can also seek some feedback from someone you know, a loved one, and ask them if you express yourself appropriately. Two, we must interact with others honestly about who we are and be open to positive criticism. As we looked at in other videos, we looked at the importance of this for self-esteem, for building character, for resilience. We have to be honest with ourselves. We have to be honest with others. We can't just pretend who we are. We have to be truly who we are. But at the same time, we have to also be open to criticism. By communicating who we are in an authentic way, we learn about ourselves. Also, we need mentors who can challenge our views and our assumptions and help us see something that we could not see on our own. Number three, we need to be good listeners and observers. This takes discipline. It takes mind and body unity to be present in the moment, to be fully focused on listening to one person. Listening in that sense is as active and as important as speaking. When both sides are talking, no one is listening. Listening involves developing sensitivity to verbal and nonverbal messages. There is a good practice that can help us become good listeners and indicate to the other person that we have understood what they are saying. This is called reflective listening. The ability to reflect the speaker's feelings and thoughts by repeating back to them what they have said. We have to concentrate on understanding and providing accurate feedback to do this while being empathetic. So practice reflective listening with a loved one. It is a process of listening actively and paraphrasing, reflecting back what was said. Without judgment or advice, once you have done this, ask your partner if they have felt listened to. Thank you for listening.